I think we all know that an esports career is not going to be like 10, 15 years. That's why we just try to make the most of what we have right now, and that's why we practice like 7 days a week. The teams that I've been in Copenhagen Wolves and NIP, I never really felt safe, or I didn't feel like the roster was really structured. You have to stay constant and you have to do your best. It's pretty overwhelming, to be honest, to get pretty much 3 MVPs within a month or two. And then I looked at someone like TSM, and their roster was extremely stable. They had a lot of the same players over a long period of time. That's something I wanted. I wanted that stability, and I wanted to be a part of something as big as TSM.
They die right off the bat, which we've seen Bjergsen be pushed out right away. It can be very bad, and Darren is just going to get 1v1 here by Bjergsen.
Yeah, he's just going to go in from the backside of it.
Dragon as well. I was completely wrong. They're the ones controlling Dragonair here. Bjergsen now.
Ooh, the Q dodge. Does he have the damage? Snoopy surely to pop right here. Now can Bjergsen get out? Oh, there you go. Jumps to his clone. Bjergsen making it look easy.
Getting in there for the fling. It looks like Copenhagen Wolves might be interested in having a go with this one. Is he going to get the fling? It's virtually thrown to the side. Freddy gets a Lulu ultimate down on him as the Zyra ulti knocks them all in the air. Slayer being absolutely destroyed as Fence Current comes in as well. There was the Lulu ultimate. It wasn't used earlier on. Bjergsen is going to kill Virtual though. Freddy going low. Nigo Pro going low. No, he's finished off. Corralius and Freddy are the only two men left alive here. GodPro is still somehow alive in this one as he flings Freddy away again.
Can we see a
what for a kill? Can he get the penta kill here? Bjergsen chasing down. Oh, he's missing just about, but then
give it to him.
Penta kill coming in for Bjergsen. And Copenhagen Wolves are going to push through here and pick up their first victory in the LCS Europe. After starting 9-0, or 0-9, they now pick up their first win. Much deserved victory here. They have played absolutely brilliantly.
I wasn't expecting anything like this when we were told that we could come boot camping in Stockholm, so it's above all my expectations. I couldn't ask for anything better than this. This is near perfect, really.
Sounds cool.
Yeah, it's very cool.
And talking about NIP, you've been in the organization Ninjas in Pyjamas now for only a couple of weeks, but how do you like it so far?
It's a lot faster than what I've, not only was, but the organizations I've been to earlier, and it's a lot more professional, it's a lot faster, it's easier. NIP is pretty much like a family, you can talk to anyone. It's not like you feel like you're just the player, that you just get ignored, pretty much. You can talk to anyone about anything.
I just play for fun, but I reached the high ranking just playing solo queue by myself. And eventually I figured, why not play some minor tournaments where maybe you can win like $50 or something, and I was like, sure. It's my hobby, but why not try to make a little bit of money out of it? And then it just slowly built up to joining the LCS, which is something I didn't even know existed.
Making the decision to drop everything, I guess, and going to the LCS actually wasn't that hard for me because I didn't have a very good school life. The biggest thing video games gave me was definitely an escape. It was a way for me to not be me and not live my own life. I could be whoever I wanted, I could do whatever I want, and that's why I spent so much time doing it.
I lack some other things, but I think my strong main thing is my mechanical skill. It's also why I play a lot of split pushers, because then I can usually 1v1 people and usually get a kill like that, because then you just abuse the mechanical skill. I just pretty much want to thank the fans, because the fans are the reason we're here, the fans are the reason that this game is so big. The fans are everything to us.
A little bit going on there as well, as Peke has to flash away. Did get stunned under the turret. He's gonna tick him down. I thought he had enough health there, but it was that final tick of the ignite.
Not a question in the mid lane. It's given Alex Ditch a bit of an advantage, but you can see the defensive ball comes out. He hasn't got shockwave. Remember, he used it a moment ago. Bjergsen will pick up Alex Ditch. Lemon Dogs has surely picked up the advantages, but Nuke is going to get dived on, has to drop the hammer, the rappel comes out. Is it going to be enough? He does get the Stefang sunk in there. Bjergsen picks up the kill.
Know that he's in there. Actually still going to throw out Irvin. He's going to catch on, push him, but he manages to condemn him and hook him and exhaust him. And just like that, Playful Tricksters away. So as teleports in, and Stopper Force doesn't catch on towards him, but doesn't matter. Cyanide's there. Bjergsen getting punted around left, right, and center. Oh, he's got through. Nearly gets on, push him. He gets him. How the hell did he pull the kill out? Playful Tricksters over the trees.
And he steps away. The stun card was pulled, but it's not going to be enough. There's a death mark down. But Makata's in there as well. There's a flash, though. Bjergsen goes around, then jumps away. Amazing from Bjergsen. And
NYM got no vision of where he possibly is, and Bjergsen is just gonna wait. Now he comes around the corner, here's the move onto Charu. Deathmark, Charu doesn't care, he's gonna let himself go down. Bjergsen on a killing spree, is now 9-1.
And I'm looking at NFT's lineup and I'm thinking, do they have the possibility to go for an early Baron? Because they have the true damage out of Nottingham. So you do see Bjergsen going in.
Full aggression from Bjergsen. He should be enough. That's going to be first blood. Luno now chasing in there. Bjergsen's going to come in. He's going a little bit too deep. He does manage to get the kill, but it may be to the detriment of his life. But no, Sniff gets caught out, turns it into a double kill.
Playing in Europe for about a year. I played on two different teams called Copenhagen Wolves and Ninjas in Pajamas, and Team Solomid was looking for a new mid laner, and I wasn't very happy in my current team, so TSM got in contact with me, and even though I hadn't been able to prove myself on international stage, they could really see how much I wanted to get there, and that was really the main reason why they took me.
Just a bit, but no change has been talked about more than TSM signing of a former NIP star Bjergsen to take over the mid lane from Reginald. And while moving almost halfway around the world and adjusting to new teammates,
he had a lot of weight coming into the team. It was either make or break it for this kid. He was either gonna crash and burn, or he was gonna bring the team into a new era. And, well, we all know what happened.
At his core, he's still a fairly shy, fairly just nerdy video game guy. And he got shot up into this limelight.
It was a bit of a risky move, because it was hit or miss. If it missed, you just failed in the eyes of many, many fans, and TSM is the biggest name within Western esports when it comes to League of Legends.
Whether I want or not want to be a shot caller, I have to be the shot caller, and I have to be the main voice, and there has to be one main voice that's going to make all the main decisions and has to be confident, and that has to be me.
I feel like the last summer split of last year, I didn't really perform to the level I wanted to, and I feel like Weizhou really did deserve the MVP award, but I feel like this split, I really tried my hardest to come back and get to the level that I was on before, and I'm just really happy I'm here.
To two, means they can continue this, and there goes Bjergsen. Is that going to get him? Fusing, oh wow, that was like 800.
Unfortunately for EG, done that much.
And there
here
it
comes
is.
The all-in from Belter, drop dangerously low. That should be enough to kill him. Doesn't even need the death mark to pop. Anyway, TSM love their underhanded fights to dive in. Goodbye, Yellow Pete. Bjergsen dropped dangerously low and jumps back. He's gonna survive. No, Kobelter actually surviving as well. Bjergsen looking to come back into this battle as well. Should be forced to run back.
And his Hydra active does not deal enough damage.
They shied away from taking turrets, but they're back to doing it again. Under 5 minute first turret. Skara very low, and whoa, they actually go toe to toe.
The switch out of the Paladin. I would love a sweeper on Bjergsen, but he has kept with the trinket ward. And he's going to go for it. Kill under turret.
Oh my gosh, he has a W coming up. He actually grabs it. They continue to follow up. A bad spot, and the W is enough of the percent burst to take it down. Let's see if Waz can really do what he needs to here. The blue buff has worn off of Bjergsen, so he is hoping for that W to come up once again.
Oh, the juke!
Oh, he just did it! He'll be able to get past the special. Is it up? Can he get the dodge? And Bjergsen flashes. That is incredible. If it works out, the level 6 has come in and he goes instantly for the ultimate, but it's going to be the death mark back on a shifter. He has the damage, he has the victory in the 1v1. First blood here. First one goes for the bone breaker to the assault battery. Again in the same vicious, the box goes down, but everybody's coloring outside the lines on this one. Dominate's going down in the fight now. Cop is the focus, the fadeaway calling. Ace in the hole, they're going to follow him to the fountain, but he finds solace there on the...
Oh my god! Quadra kill! Quadra kill coming in for Bjergsen! The Nexus turrets will fall! Behind the 30-minute clock, 16-6, Team Solo Mid crowns out.
Don't have mana, just have the Spear Stone and Boots. It would serve him well to just farm up to level 6.
Well, level 6, Bjergsen hits it in the middle of the wave! That's gonna be enough! And the Ignite, they're in the playful tricks, so he just makes it look good.
Kobelter outplays him in a 1v1, that's about all they can hope for. The ultimates are rightly being focused in bottom.
There's a bit of that wave clear we were talking yikes. About. He has it now, the yikes for sure! Oh, Chum the Waters is only gonna hurt a little bit.
Immediately knew what to do to get back at them. Knowing that the dragon was so early, fight mid.
Oh, Bjergsen going hard. Oh, very nice.
Got him.
Oh, the ignite goes down, the turret shot hit. That's why you didn't see more damage come on, because he had already taken the damage. He gets out alive.
Wave crashing into this turret, which means it's
ready.
Yeah,
there
the kill!
Bjergsen! threading the needle onto Bunny Fufu. Another one. Cock just dodges it out with a 90 caliber net. Dyrus is in this one, strong with the dragon in the set. Two people. The flash again. He takes down the spider as Dominate crumbles up. Cock's going to be the next one. Where's the spear? Does he give it to his team? No, he takes the double kill. A triple kill on the run for everyone. Boy Boy's the next one. Bjergsen looking for the second quadra overall on Nidalee, and he gets it in the long chase.
This one, TSM, ready to play aggressive. Pobelk gets done up. There comes the ulti as well. Huge damage comes through. The char misses. Down goes Pobelter. Good trap there by Bjergsen. Comes in from the javelin, but still the smite coming in.
They're
it's
so
gonna be gone.
Low.
Bjergsen gets the damage onto Pobelter. It's going to be the pickup there for Wild Turtle. And a double kill though for Inox. They're still trying the odd one. One hit from dead. It's going to be the trade for Bjergsen. Triple kill. Yellow Pete looks for the damage. The net, not quite enough damage. Pobelter does not land it. Flashed away after the kill. Looks like 3 versus 3 in kills.
CLG hasn't even looked for an initiation. Tidal wave is available. It does get thrown down. Dyrus turns into a surfer, but it's too late to super minions off through both of the lanes. That's a knockup now from Odd One. Dyrus gets pulled back. If Dyrus is the only victim, this will be a win for TSM. That's a great play. Expansion flashes forward. The Culling gets thrown down, and Dexter eats most of the hits. He's the first victim of CLG, as Nien has respawned. He's back in the fight. He's taken Mundo down. This is turning messy. Bjergsen's got a double kill. Link forced away. That's a triple kill for Bjergsen. That's a quadra kill for Bjergsen. He's looking for the pincer. Can he get it? That's the question. Bjergsen leaves one more hit. That's a pincer kill. Bjergsen grabs 5. He puts TSM into a deciding game. Team Solo Mid have beaten Counter Logic Gaming.
Definitely having the upper hand here, but there's no more slow to be applied.
Yeah, he's doing a great job. I'd say Inox is outplaying Dyrus in that matchup just to stay even at this point.
Gotta watch Pobelter. Amazing on the other side. Gets himself very nicely away. That is gonna be a dead Pobelter.
Wow. Even with the two Dorians, Bjergsen knew exactly how much damage.
Does walk right in to Dominate, and he's gonna have to have amazing save him here.
Heals in. CX Special with the roam coming up the top. Gleep is actually coming up behind. If they can fit them into that pocket, give them some false reassurance here. Bjergsen takes one down. Gleep is making it in time and forces the flash from Special. The cocoon hits. The follow-up damage is there. And Bjergsen's tank build coming into play huge.
On Bjergsen, switching target. They might be able to capitalize.
Oh, he goes back in. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, oh, he goes back in. The healing's going to be there. Will he actually be able to rock this out? The double kill. This shouldn't kill him. And he makes it out alive.
Good move so far. Great trade. Dragon for turret. Quas getting a little caught up. They converge onto him in the jungle.
Throwing it out. Bjergsen huffs that one.
Is going down, Kobe.
Clean sweep.
Oh man,
Bjergsen.
High five over to Doublelift. He goes down instantly. No chance to get away from the scatter.
I think wanting to have a little bit of choice in who he targets. Amazing, trying to make a big play.
Holy.
Oh, Bjergsen,
what a scatter of the week. I'd say that was level. Double kill coming up for Bjergsen. That's going to be huge. He will live in that top lane as he limps away. And they are just scratching each other's eyes in this bot lane.
One more.
One more.
Oh, no.
Sticks his head in the shell and he's able to stay alive.
He dodges the last two. And now Bjergsen.
Oh, he's going crazy. Oh, he gets a kill. You gotta be kidding me. And he blows Crumbs' flash. It's gonna last for quite a long time. And
red buff slow.
Forces a flash. Here comes Amazing. The blood boil is only on him, so he's gotta wait for that cooldown. Oh my gosh. Bjergsen comes up with a solo kill.
Yeah, they got panicked.
Wall, four under wall.
On these outer turrets, the wall.
Oh, Bjergsen kicked to the side. That's a sloppy start.
Whoa. Glacial Fissure goes in. No name again being the focus of that Bjergsen ultimate. And they begin to scatter LMQ. They find a fight that they get to initiate. Vasily does 1v1 out of kill for himself. But it's a triple kill for Bjergsen to come in. He starts to put his own numbers on the board.
No name has not been able to create any plays. And Dyrus is running amok.
Completely. He only has a short range. There's one. Dyrus flashes to make sure the vision stays.
TSM, an early game lead here, getting that kill and maybe leading to a second turret is pretty important, but the gank and miss.
unfortunate. The flash is already down. Bjergsen got himself caught up in that hole. Summoners, but he answers back onto high.
TSM might still go in, though.
Trying to cover from the backside. A great calling. It's going to be stopped, though. No, he actually dodges out with the round. The pursuit to keep some shots coming in. A kill coming in from Sneaky. Uses the heal to keep the team healthy, but it takes. Actually, he goes down to the ignite.
Triple kill.
Love this. We're getting out a great fourth game here. 230 in. Everybody's still being level one. High coming in at level two, so he can actually provide quite a bit of damage or protection for the team.
Really nice flash there by Darius to keep himself safe. TSM still trying to make this collapse happen because they have the number advantage.
Bjergsen's got only range. He didn't take the stun, so it's everything they can hit now. High goes down. That three just comes back up. He is able to head for home on
well,
this one. He's not going to give
he's
up.
He's got backup again.
Trying orb coming in. That's one. And he hits the last one over the shoulder. Might get their pinch initiations in. Oh, Lord.
They caught him.
Sneaky getting caught. Not even enough time to Valkyrie.
Figure in the esports industry. Bjergsen is not expected to just go even. Bjergsen is expected to transcend that. He has to win every time. And if Bjergsen doesn't win by 10 or 20 CS in his lane, that means Bjergsen lost.
I had my start where I was a rookie, and now I'm in a space where I feel like I'm very comfortable with my team. I'm very confident. Wait, is this my chance at Worlds? Is this my only chance?
Ice content sitting on his turret.
Oh,
he's done
coming out. That's going to be it. Santora not even needed.
Will they stay is the question. Bjergsen puts out a lot of pressure. No charge. Binding was close, though.
Wow.
Oh, my God. Goes in. Takes him down.
Another dragon.
Oh, there's the scrying orb again. And it comes up big once more. One by one. Less ults than last time. Zion Spartan again in Meganar form. He's going to be able to do a bit of zoning. The Pope from Doublelift has already started to put TSM down. That Link ultimate just off the edge. This could be the comeback here for Team Solo Mid. The ult goes in. That's onto Santorin. He's pretty tanky from the Vi Assault and Battery, so he stays alive. They continue to fight. Bjergsen back in. He hits a Foxfire. Now going for another one. He's going to get a double kill. Bjergsen starts to pull the team back in the game as they control the fights together. Some damage in this fight. I don't know if he'll be back in time. He tries to instantly teleport. They're going to be able to see this coming in.
Oh!
The dragon gets hit up. No way! Bjergsen takes the dragon. He's still in the mix, and Gravity's health bars are just getting blown apart right now. Three are already down. TSM is having a heyday here, 24 minutes in. That's a double kill for Bjergsen, the triple kill for him.
Step one and five, i.e., he's gonna go after this tank.
He's going quite hard. He actually flashes forward to finalize the damage, and he pulls right back to the alt shadow. Oh, what? Dodging back and forth, the fancy feed.
I want to die to the wombo combo. Calitrol spotted by Bjergsen. Root. Slow's not going to land for much. Calitrol's trying to get away, but this is going to be a kill for Bjergsen. Takes him down 1v1 as payment of dragon.
Bjergsen going to solo him
coming
again.
For Calitrol's. E over.
They hear the CC.
Jumps
there's
up.
The...
Yeah. Ignite saw it. That's a kill.
Top lane for quite some time as they farm it out. 73 to 60. Kobelter, he could get hit up here. That's going to be what it needs. And
oh,
the lockdown
man.
As he hits the shuriken off his shadow.
Oh,
this could be TSM's chase.
Slow.
A great glitter lance onto the team. That could be Avalon going in for the team, but Winterfox actually wants it as well. That was a mistake. Here goes Bjergsen in. This is what TSM wanted. They are just shredding Winterfox out now.
There you go. Big lightning storm comes in, and now it's expanding off of the side. Gets the death mark on him, flashes the wall. Bjergsen chases. Looks like he might get the kill, and he will. Out he goes. One for zero, chase on Bjergsen, though Link likely to get this kill. The rocket misses, the charm misses, Bjergsen gets out.
Side of Cloud9. Hello. Oh my word!
Whoa.
I was gonna say he's getting dinner, but that would look like an appetizer.
Yeah, and Bjergsen's level 16 right now, which means his ultimate does over 1,000 true damage. Cloud9 has to fight, but look out!
It's the go for broke here from Cloud9 on their front doorstep. They try one last time to stave off Team Solomon.
Thank you. symbol of superiority, an inspiration to every player. The best in the world are here for this, the World Championship Trophy.
Getting together, they're going in. Oh, they're going to get this thing down instantly. They're flag and drag away. Well, they're going to keep chasing. Bjergsen, what leaping throw down. That's a double for Mystic now. The rest of the team try and back away. Bjergsen will mop up a kill in favor of TSM. But another double stun from Lustoy comes out, and they've managed to down a Luka, who's going to come back up here, cause them some problems. The Dyrus will fall. Lustoy's going to go down. Bjergsen, though, is still alive to get himself the double. And there is another one. It's a triple kill. And in the end, it's going to be an for Team Solo Mid.
Yeah, he just said he knows when to back away. Sorda actually going incredibly low from that one. Bjergsen will flash through, gets the kill.
How strong in the sign with TP is down towards the bottom lane in case any ganks happen. Because obviously now you're waiting to see what Bjergsen is doing this trade. He's going in.
Oh, he took the tower hit there as Maple. Don't think the Death Knight's got quite enough damage with the shuriken from the side. Played that by Bjergsen, maybe a misplay from Maple.
You want that tanky frontline deal with this that's coming
exactly
in right now.
They're expecting to engage.
Oh, Lustboy is going to pretty much miss everything there. And actually, they have had to use summon a heal on him. That's probably not good. Santorin, though, right in the middle with Wild Growth on. They managed to pick up NL. They're going to get Karsa here as well. Bjergsen will get that for the double. And I think this might be a cleanup.
America versus China. Intel Extreme Masters World Championship Final. This is a matchup that's going to go down in history.
Bjergsen continues to shove that mid wave. He's getting him in a little bit for free.
Oh, Bjergsen going for this one. I think he might have got the damage as well. He will. First blood for Bjergsen. One versus one. Sertzlu already used his Valkyrie, and he's down and out of this one. Dyrus will jump into the middle. Where is the Zhonya's? He gets the stun. Zhonya's will be used. Yusha is going to go down, and Dyrus will fall just after, and that leaves Bjergsen all on his own in the middle of the pack. He'll try and get off to the backside. Yusha not taking enough damage as Bjergsen jukes off onto his shadows, and I think he's managed to escape this one.
It is not looking good, because if you do swap out to 1-3-1, you're going to die in the sideways. Let's see Wild Turtle, though. He jumped on.
Oh, the owner ultimate does come through, but Spirit going low, and he'll be finished. Bjergsen pounces in from the side. They've taken the dragon. They've got 3-4 kills now, and that just went from bad to worse for World Elite. He'll control this bottom side of the map. Spirit is somewhat alone. Plus does have... Oh, the ultimate going through just in time, and that will be Spirit dead to you. Bjergsen now unstoppable at 5-0-4.
And right here, it's really... You can see how far behind this Caitlyn is in terms of the power spike. There's the ult on the Shia.
Not much more to be said, really. Spirit, though, is going to try and kill off Wild Turtle, but he's bitten off more than he can chew. It's actually Bjergsen who will get it with the Ignite. They lock up Mystic as well.
I took losing very, very hard. I would kind of sink into this hole of depression. What could I have done? What could I have done? What could I have done to win this game or do anything different? Maybe I do suck. Maybe all of these bad things they're saying about me are true.
I think Bjergsen in a 1v1 scenario is probably the best player in the world. And I would rank Bjergsen above Faker in terms of being a better overall player, because of how he has grown with his team, the fact that he's a shot caller, we know that, and also the fact he plays multiple play styles.
Yeah. Dyrus took so much damage there.
When that hook was down, they felt very comfortable going in. The rocket missing just over the shoulder of Phoenix. The turret's down, the inhibitor now to follow. The Where's soldiers Piglet? Are in. Santorin makes his way into the fight as well. He's on to Quas. Especially with Piglet on the back line, and Piglet has no mana and no range on the fight. There's a Blade of the Rune King, though. They're able to take down Lustboy. Bjergsen comes in. There's the shot. God. There's the triple. Could that be the quadra? And Bjergsen picks up a beautiful play. Oh, Dyrus. Could be an ultimate. Eyes still on Dyrus. He's able to throw Zion Spartan back. It's still tanky, and that's going to give the team enough time.
Bardo.
That's double lift and Smithy in the Bardo. Double lift can still start to kite back. pole vaulter was just on the outside, but it's a triple kill for Bjergsen. The team was able to start kiting and make it happen. It is going to be Lustboy going down as double lift and pole vaulter now run for the hills. Bjergsen should be able to close the gap as he's going the long way around. He will get the cut. Double lift will get hit, but they focus pole vaulter so they can clean up both of them. That's the mirror image. He's going to be able to get back in for the double kill, and TSM now capitalizes on a CLG error.
He knows he's got a one versus one this time, but because of the previous ganks, he's too far behind.
If Bjergsen gets this kill, that was a perfect outplay on the Hunter. Miss, that was actually an explosive shot by Altec onto the minion. They can't add too much damage. A nice equalizer over three members, but it's not cooking too many. They move off it immediately. Bjergsen on the other side, shifting back over the Shurima slide to safety. Jungle with 600-700 HP. No matter what kind of tank you are, Bjergsen quarantines gravity into the wall with Emperor's Defiant, and it looks like Altec is able to take down Lustboy. He dives in, Bjergsen stabs him right in the throat with a soldier and takes him down. Santorin and Bjergsen in the same HP bowl right now, absolutely taking down gravity as the rest of the team stands on the front line.
Onto Phoenix, he may be too far. Perfect Narbar adjustment for the fight.
He's going to be able to stand there toe-to-toe with four members of Team Liquid. Five members of Team Liquid, but one has already gone down, and Dyrus walks out, so the team can now go in and finish the rest of the damage. A nice ultimate in. It divides the entire team of Liquid, and they get taken down surgically by Team Solar.
Super Fizz, a trade from Dyrus. He's running away. One more hit'll do it, but Bjergsen takes him down.
Gamsu on the backside kills Kalista as well, and now time for some action.
Oh,
not anywhere offensive right now. Another W comes in, looks for Kiwi, can get some. Now to chase on him, but the shark drops him dangerously low. The Bard Q will not do much, but Wild Turtle's already here to play cleanup. Two kills picked so far. One more stun attempt for the Echo. Wild Turtle goes Gamsu and loses it.
In, then Dyrus gets a big wave. Before it was down to some that he got the wave, and
that was not a good decision. Bjergsen,
oh, I missed that one.
He missed him for the kill for Bjergsen in the 1v1.